So today we are going to start with the demography lecture number 5, and we will be discussing how the population of our country gets changed. So we all know that there are special vital events which change the population, and we have discussed in our last lectures that these are births, deaths, marriages and divorces, which mainly affect the population of our country. In addition to these vital events, in-migration and out-migration also affect the population of a specific area. How the population changes, that there are three main trends. Number one is the rapid growth. If the birth rate is high and death rate is low, definitely the population grows at a very rapid rate. And if the population in the reproductive age group is much more, which is giving birth to newborn babies, it means the population is growing rapidly. Slow growth is shown by those countries where the birth rate is low, but the death rate is also low because of the prevailing health conditions and the better healthcare service provision. The slow birth rate indicates the provision of family planning services and the awareness level of the population for the use of the family planning methods. Zero growth shows that the births are equalizing the number of deaths. It means that whatever the number of births is occurring in a population, it gets neutralized by the number of deaths in that population. So overall, the population is not growing. It means it is showing zero growth. Zero growth is possible only whenever there is replacement level fertility is exhibited by that population. It means that a couple who is fertilized produces only two children, it gives birth to only two children during their reproductive lifespan. And it means that the two adults are replaced by two children, one male and one female, who will replace them in future. So there is zero population growth. Zero population growth cannot be attained until and unless we attain the replacement level fertility. If the replacement level fertility is not attained, then the population shows the increasing trend. For attaining the replacement level fertility, on average 2.1 births should be given per woman. Why not 2 and why 2.1? Because this 0.1 gives us an extra margin to replace the number of deaths which occur in children less than 5 years of age. So to compensate the expected deaths, the replacement level fertility is not placed strictly at the level 2, but it is said that to maintain the equilibrium, on average, a woman should give two births of 2.1 in their reproductive lifespan. These are practically not possible that a female gives birth to 2.1 children, but statistically we say that if a female is producing two children and if another female is producing three children and another there is infertile couple, then on average, on mean, they can be taken as 2.5 births per woman. So statistically these values are calculated, and 2.1 births per woman end up in zero population growth rate of a country. It is being estimated that the population, which has a large number of people in the reproductive age group, even if we provide a rapid services for the family planning method and we want to reduce the velocity, the mass of the population is as such that it will continue to grow. It means that currently, if we have a large number of population which is in the reproductive age group in Pakistan, as shown by the population pyramid, and we ask the population to attain the replacement level fertility, that each married couple will produce only two children, just enough to replace them, then even the population will continue to grow for a specific time period. There will be no decline in the population momentum. So it means that all those populations will continue to grow in near future who have a larger bulk in the middle of the population pyramid. This is to show you that on average, initially in Pakistan, on average, a female was producing 5 to 6 children on average about 15 to 20 years ago. And now the females in Pakistan are producing 4 children. But to attain the replacement level fertility, if we bring it to 2 even, then the population will continue to grow for even next coming 30 years, because the mass in the reproductive age group is so much that we cannot control the population momentum. It will continue to grow for next 30 years even if we attain the population replacement level fertility at this point in time. So demographic transition can be explained in such a way that there are different patterns. For example, in early pre-industrial area, there was high fertility and high mortality. On average, the females were producing more than 8 to 9 children. There was no availability of the family planning methods. There was no education, and there was no methods known to females for birth spacing. So there was high fertility in that era. But in the same time, the mortality rate was really high, not only in children under 5 years of age, but also in females because of the repeated births and sufferings, multiple anemias and pregnancy-related complications resulted in high mortality. Even in that era, the mortality occurred because of a large number of epidemics, which resulted, for example, in plague, tuberculosis, cholera epidemics. And there were many communicable diseases which were resulting in a large number of deaths in that era. So about 15 to 70 years ago, the pattern which was shown by the population was the pattern of high fertility and high mortality. With modernization and provision of the birth control methods, and by increasing the awareness, by increasing the female literacy, by increasing the female employment status, the fertility showed a lower pattern. And now there is a trend in certain parts of the world where the females are only producing 1 children. They are not even attaining the replacement level fertility. It means to maintain the growth of the population, we should attain a replacement level fertility. There are many countries which are not in, where the females are not producing even 2 children. They are opting for not producing children, or they are producing only 1 child in their reproductive span. So really the fertility rate is very low in those countries. And the example is Germany, Sweden, Norway, where the population is growing into negative balance. In these countries, the mortality rate is also very low because of the provision of better healthcare services. The geriatric population is increasing. So low fertility and low mortality is currently shown in developed countries across the globe. But there are many countries which show still a high fertility pattern. For example, in Pakistan and in India and in Bangladesh, still the females prefer to produce 3 to 4 children. They know about the provision of birth spacing. They know about the consequences of having a large number of children. And in those countries, the mortality rate has reduced because they are developing and they have opted for modern services, and their geriatric population is increasing. These countries are in the stage of late expanding, that their population is increasing because of the high fertility and low mortality patterns. This is to show you the demographic cycle, which shows us multiple stages. In stage 1, you can see the fertility, the birth rate and death rates were compensating each other. So there was no increase in the population. You can see that the birth rates were high, the death rates were high, and the population was not increasing. In the stage 2, the birth rates still remained very high, but the death rates started declining because of the control of the epidemics and the control of communicable diseases. This was the stage when there was increase in the population was observed, and this increase was known as the natural increase. In stage 3, the death rate still continued to reduce a lot, and the people became aware of the family planning services and the birth rate started declining. But this is the phase where we are in Pakistan, in which the birth rate has shown slight decline, the death rate is declining, but we are continuously expanding because of the population momentum. And then there is stage 4, which says that the birth rate is low and death rate is too low and they are neutralizing, and it again goes into the stationary phase. The stage 1 was observed in the pre-industrial area, as I have discussed, and the population growth rate was very low. In stage 2, the early industrial phase was obtained and the rapid increase in the population was observed in that phase. In stage 3, as the birth rate is declining, but still the population is increasing. So it's known as late expanding. In stage 4, which is the post-industrial phase in which many developed countries are there, again, the growth rate is very, very slow. The demographic cycle is described in 5 stages, which says that high stationary phase shows high birth rate, high death rate, and natural increases not observed there. The second stage is early expanding, which we have discussed, that the birth rates are still high, but death rates start declining, and there is slow increase in the population. Then late expanding phase, in which the birth rates are still very high, death rates are low, and this is increasing at a rapid rate, which is known as population momentum. And then the low stationary phase, in which the birth rate is declining, death rate is declining, and the population is growing, but as the death rates and birth rates are compensating each other, so the increase is slow. And the fifth stage is known as declining phase, where the population goes into the negative balance because the birth rates are really low and they are not even getting the replacement level. Death rates are low and the population is going into zero balance or it is going into the negative values. Population growth rate means a rate at which a population is expected to increase over a period of time. As you can see that there are less developed countries have a high birth rate and the population is expected to increase at a very rapid rate. So there are countries which are showing increasing trends, and China has forced law enforcement that the population was only allowed to produce only one child for nearly last 30 years. So they have controlled their population expansion. And now currently in 2017, they have allowed the population to produce children. Otherwise, the penalty was given to the Chinese population if they wanted to produce more than one child. In the less developed country, those countries where the population is going into the negative trend, it shows the growth rate is in minus. The growth rate is shown as in percentages per year. Population doubling time means this is the time period for which is required by a population to double itself. It is said that if a population is increasing at a rate of 1%, it will take 70 years to double itself. So whenever you want to calculate the population doubling time, you will divide the value of 70 by the growth rate and you will come to know about the population doubling time of that population. Fine. So demographic equation, as we have already discussed, that if we know the population of a country and we know that how the births and deaths are occurring in that country, how the in-migrations and out-migrations are registered in net migration registers, we can calculate the change in population. As you can see, the natural increase is based on birth minus death, and the net migration is based on the in-migration minus out-migration. This is the population of a country at a specific time period, and this is the change in the population which can be predicted by knowing all those parameters. So depending upon these values, you have to calculate this numerical. It says that our town, Tarogil, has more than 20,000, has 20,000 people, and the statistics are given that there are 2,000 births, there are 7,000 new residents who have immigrated, there were 1,500 deaths, and there were 800 people who have moved away. So what was the number of people 2 years ago in this town? So using the population equation, you can calculate this and you have to submit this assignment to me. Moving forward, we can also calculate the change in population by knowing the growth rates and the difference between the two population in terms of times. So this is PT1, means the population in a specific time period which has to be calculated, the population which was known before a certain time period. One is constant, R is growth rate, and T is the time period between these two population differences. So if this population was taken 10 years ago and this population is, we want to calculate after 10 years, so T will be equal to 10 years. So using this equation, you have to calculate the growth rate of this place. Calculate the growth rate of this place. Moving forward, the range of growth rate is different in different parts of the world. So in developing countries, it is 1.48. In least developed countries, it is more than the replacement level fertility. So population is increasing, for example, in Kenya, in South Africa, in Ghana, etc., even in Pakistan. And in more developed countries, it is less than 1 even, in which it is 0.30, which shows that the population is going into the negative balance. So calculate the time period in this numerical. You have to calculate the percentage growth rate by looking into the change in this population. Calculate population doubling time in this numerical. And that's the end of today's lecture. Please submit your assignments to me by the given time, which I will post on the Facebook. Thank you so much.